Yo, what's up? This is Vicky the Great. Yeah. And now I don't know what to say next. But okay, cool. On the real, what? I think basically the buzz at the moment is around the submission, which is going to be my official debut project, which is due for release as we are speaking now. Today is the what? The what, 9th, I think? 9th, right? Of August, right? 2016. So we're 2 weeks away basically from the official release of the submission, which is pretty like exciting. It's a very exciting moment right now in my life, basically personally, and also as an artist, as a musician at the very same time. Now, late submission, man. I don't know, man. Like, what can I say about late submission? Official setup of late submission was not really planned, you know. Like, late submission sort of came about on a whim, you know. Like, you as an artist, you find yourself like involved in so many things and so many projects, and then after some time nothing happens and it's so quiet, right? And then like get an urge, or rather I got an urge, like something needs to happen now, you know. And I decided, like, you know what, since, well, basically, like, as I was performing in the scenes, basically, you know, people been asking me, like, yo, V, when are you releasing a project? You're doing an album, you're releasing a track here and there, I've heard you perform here and there, are you doing an album, things like that. And I was like, you know what, might as well basically just get in the water basically and get wet. And it was a pretty cool experience, I can tell you that. Yeah, man, like late submission, that's how late submission came about. So far as the general idea and the general concept of late submission is concerned, phrase it, I'd say this submission is like, it's not really an orthodox project, you know. Like don't follow, like I don't follow like the rules, you know. Like, if we're saying like there's rules, I don't follow many of them. I think I break like a couple of rules with this submission, so far as the definition of what like a typical hip-hop artist is supposed to be doing or things like that, you know. Like, yeah, man, there's a mishmash like of flavors there, and I pretty much love basically everything that came through, especially with the kinds of contributions that actually I had from people who were helping me with the project, you know, like people like my main person, who basically I was like, you know, like this person like needs to be the main contributor. I think it's going to be with this project and with many other projects to come in the future, is like Vertical X, you know, simply because we have a common understanding when it comes to like music, basically the approach of music, like how much he appreciates music and how much I appreciate music, what he sees as music and what I see as music. There's many similarities and there's much basically gel going on around there, you know. So when I was with him, basically it was a matter of, Joe, just give me what you want to do, no? Not basically what's happening around, not basically what's hot at the moment, not really what's making, you know, like the hype at the moment. Let's just do basically what you want to do, like as an artist, you know. And like you know, and as soon as like the tracks came through, it was a matter of, oh fuck no, shit, I have to make as much justice as possible to these creations because they were a work of art, like on a serious note, basically, like, yeah, like they were like particularly unique. And then yes, on late submission, basically with like since it also is like is a pretty extensive project. I think there's 14 tracks. There's also other people basically who contributed to the project. You know, there's Ilsik. He has so many names. I don't know who these other names were, like Ilsik. We also have Methodist and Dogsman. Oh yeah, not to forget Moscato. Like he basically sort of like did a track there because he sort of like liked what was happening. It was pretty cool. Yeah, man. Some of the tracks basically were tracks that were originally already there, like amongst peers and people sort of like knew, but nobody, not everyone actually knew. So what happened was a matter of, hey man, like I wanted to redo the songs simply because I wanted to get like the official expression of the songs, because I thought like they actually deserved it, especially track like the Many Few. Basically, there's a reason why the Many Few had to like had to be redone and basically put there, despite it being a song I think it's already 2 or 3 years old right now, for people who actually sort of like know the song. The main reason is because one, the song started everything, right? Like it's the song that actually started this whole buzz about Biggie the Great, like as an on-stage rapper, as a guy basically who gets in the studio and records like rap tracks, you know, if you would basically to put it that way. Also, it basically introduced the whole concept or the idea of Biggie the Great to people basically on a much larger scale. So I sort of like felt like this track basically deserved to be given a little bit more attention and consideration, so far as the handling and putting the hands on the song, you know? That's how the submission basically is packaged, you know. Like if we were to talk about personal favorite tracks, I think I love all of the songs there. You know, it's my right basically to like all of the songs, but there's exceptional tracks maybe, you know, like pick from the rest. I would say The Joke, you know, The Joke, which is going to be track number 4 on the project. You know, The Joke is one of those, man. Like the script is well written, like the script is well written. I like what I did basically with the presentation when I sort of like recorded it. And I also love the instrumental, man, like because it doesn't follow the usual hip hop sound, you know. It's a very gloomy, you know, darkish jazz type of expression, and like the movement is slow at the very same time it's very pacey, you know, which is like completely bonkers, like which is why, you know, some of the people who actually heard it like no, I wanna, like if you're gonna shoot a video, man, that's the track you wanna shoot a video for. It's like, yeah, that's pretty cool, it's pretty awesome. Like we'll see that, we'll see what's gonna happen. Another track would be Mario Thoughts. I love Mario Thoughts, man. Like, I love Mario Thoughts. All of the versions of Mario Thoughts themes are pretty awesome. You know, because like Mario Thoughts, man, it was a test, you know, of like a test for me basically as a writer. When I was writing the script, I was not sure basically if I could sort of like accomplish something like that. Because someone else actually gave me the concept, like, yo, V, here's, like, I hear you do all of this thing, you perform, you do all of this poetry and whatever, but, like, you most likely sort of, like, float in a specific direction, you know? Like, okay, cool. And then I was like, nah, man, like, it's not really like that. Wow, okay, cool. Like, give me a concept, let us see basically if I can't do it. And then, like, the person was like, okay, cool, here's a concept, you know? And I had to take that basically and do as much as I can with it. And to great fortune, basically, it became a legendary concept on its own, basically, in a beautiful track, and which is pretty awesome. Yeah. what else is there to say? Basically, late submission is late submission, man. Yeah. Like, I think basically this is the reason why I actually had to name it late submission is, you know, it proves itself, right? Because like the project was completely finished for recording, like the recording everything, like recording everything and basically lacing down all of the vocals, the like everything and mixing. I think it was done by the last week of December. Everything was pretty much like packaged up, and then it was scheduled for release in February. That didn't happen. Already it was late because already people were sort of like, yeah man, like when is this thing of yours coming out? You know, when is this thing of yours coming out? And then February came through, that didn't happen, you know, because you have to think about, like, especially as an independent artist, man, like there's three things basically you have to figure out, you know, like you have to learn new things, like new things sort of like come into your reality, things like the funding, you know, things getting the right kind of engineers into your sound, things like you know, having other people sort of like improve your work and actually make it a little bit better than what it actually is right now at the moment, so that when the people get it, you know, they get something that's on point, which basically is also a belief of mine, because I really wouldn't like to give anyone or basically put work that I'm not basically happy with, especially with the kind of mouth that I have, you know, like as people who know me, they know, maybe the great original class one asshole, you know, I talk a lot, so basically I have to also show for it. I think it's a decency of mine. So yeah man, like that basically took its toll, basically the funding, the whatevers, you know, the this and that, the little stuff basically to sort of like make sure that basically this thing would be sort of like an on-point release, you dig? And now all of that is done with, and I'm pretty happy now, and basically I think that late submission basically is going to satisfy a lot of people, you know, a lot of people, like your typical everyday music lover, your heavy hip-hop hit, you know, the heavy hip-hop, you know, hit, the mature person basically who's like, who wants something that, you know, laid back, chilled and grown up, you know, that's the kind of sound basically that I was traveling with the late submission. Not really that I planned it, just happened with what was happening, you know. Yeah man, like a lot of people are gonna like it, some people might not like it, and if you don't like it, like I said, give it to the next friend, eh? You know, like late submission, here it is, recommend to a patient, you know, recommend to a patient, customer friend, you know, serve to a hungry person. Oh yeah, yeah man, like, so yeah, it was a beautiful experience. And to sum it up, basically late submission, however people are going to receive it, this project is the sum of all my experience and lack of experience, basically. It is the sum of all of that, like my experience and inexperience, which basically makes it late submission a very like honest project, you know, it makes it a very honest project. And if you aren't satisfied with this, don't worry, you know, Wrong Class is on its way. I'm currently working on Wrong Class. I think right now I have around about four tracks basically complete, not on record, but like the scripts, the lyrics basically are done with, and yeah, there's also some beautiful scripts that I basically wrote, especially like this one Mike Chat, which I was like writing recently, so expect that, wait for that. Or maybe I can mix it up, like maybe flavor up, but nah, Oh yeah, that's me. Good Feel a Great Day Submission, June. I think anytime from the 19th of August 2016, we should be getting Late Submission. Most likely, like mostly basically, it's going to be digital. Physical, we're still basically talking like that with my team, basically, like, okay, come on, we're gonna do it, yes or no. But I think also it's, you know, your choice. If you want physical copies, basically, yeah, you can definitely hit us up, and we can see if we can sort of get that.